Tonight on KAPP KVEW Local News at 6, women rescued from sex trafficking in the Tri-Cities. Tonight, the organization stepping in to help after a massage parlor sting.
And it's an important day in Washington state history, the decades-old eruption that literally reshaped the landscape.
And the heat is on, along with some muggy and humid conditions. Jason will show us how hot the weekend will be in your First Alert forecast.
Now, KAPP KVEW Local News at 6.
We begin with breaking news. Police are searching for a 2-year-old from Idaho who may be in Oregon or Washington tonight. Police in Nampa, which is just west of Boise, say 2-year-old Rudy Reyes was taken by his father, Rudolfo Reyes, who does not have custody. That happened, they say, just before 11 this morning. Police say the older Reyes is known to carry a pistol. They may be driving a gray Honda Civic with the Idaho license plate 019Y0R.
Investigators said earlier this evening they may be headed toward Pendleton, Oregon, but that's been updated. And investigators say they may be headed for Rochester, which is northwest of Centralia. If you have any information, call 911 right away. You can also contact the Nampa Police Department. We have the information to do that, plus more pictures of these two on our website, yaktrinews.com.
Thanks for joining us this evening. I'm Alyssa Warner.
And I'm Madeline Hagan.
We're taking a look outside tonight. You can see the diminished air quality in our region right now. We're seeing air quality has been kind of steadily dropping over the past 24 hours. You can blame that on the wildfire smoke from huge fires in Canada.
This is a look at the current air quality conditions. You can see a lot of our area is at moderate. Taking a live look outside tonight, just that haze coating the area. We barely see the mountains off in the distance. So if you are sensitive to particle pollution, you should start taking steps to limit your exposure. It is also very hot outside. Jason Valentine is tracking your First Alert weather forecast.
Good Thursday evening, everyone. Hope you're having a wonderful day today. And folks, hope you have a great weekend planned. We have really nice conditions on the way. Overnight tonight, we're going to see clearing into tomorrow and plenty of sunshine. We do have highs in the mid to lower 90s, and we do expect to be breaking some records tomorrow. And it looks like we'll be breaking those records on Saturday. So could see a hint of shower activity, Yakima, Ellensburg area as we head into the evening hours tonight, but then they'll be seeing some clearing as well. And as we move into Sunday, though, we have much cooler temperatures on the way, so do get ready for that. We're going to be back to the 80s, and then by next week we're going to be in the upper 70s to lower 80s. So we do have relief from this heat on the way, but again, record-breaking heat for many of our cities starting tomorrow into our Saturday. So folks, get ready for beautiful blue skies and plenty of sunshine to come, even when we cool down. All that, my full forecast coming up, but for right now, I'm going to send it back to you.
Thanks, Jason. It's the third massage parlor raid since March of this year. On Tuesday, 6 in Kennewick were searched and shut down. KPD says 4 of the businesses had women who were being sex trafficked. Tonight we hear from Mir Ministries, who says the demand for these illicit businesses has to end.
She saw the underwear in the basket and she got super excited and she picked it up and she asked if she could have it. And we told her yes, and she started crying. She says the whole package. A lot of times girls that are being used in this way aren't allowed underwear because it's just superfluous and gets in the way. So it's also a dignity thing, right? Takes that dignity away.
A simple garment and a way out. Trisha McFarland and her team with Mir Ministries was on the scene to help victims of trafficking.
We are simply here for victim services. Law enforcement just likes to have that victim support there right away. Their job is in this lane, so they bring us in for that other lane.
Out of the 6 massage parlors, Kennewick police say 4 were found to have been selling sexual services. McFarland says it's shocking, but not uncommon.
The Tri-Cities is an awesome community, but we're a community full of humans. And everywhere around the world, there's this issue of those who are vulnerable and those who are going to exploit the vulnerable.
Investigators nor Trisha could share much about the victims, but we do know out of 9 women, 4 are getting help from Mir Ministries. McFarland says oftentimes victims of trafficking are tricked and then become trapped.
Very often they're promised things that aren't what they appeared to be when they were promised. Documents are taken from them. Threats are made, or they're just shamed into a point where they feel like that's the only option that they have.
McFarland says they're able to get these women into safe homes. She's already heard from a couple of the victims.
They just texted back to our hotline and said, thank you so much. You made me feel loved. You made me feel safe. Nobody's ever done that before.
Tricia hopes more people will sound the alarm about illegal activities like this, helping to end the demand for sex trafficking.
Consensual sex would not include money. Consensual sex, if somebody's truly consenting, would not include a commercial exchange. So if you see something, say something. You may be that one person who spoke up and made a difference for them.
And KPD said no arrests have been made yet in this investigation. I did ask them if there's any safeguards in place to ensure these business owners can't open up another massage parlor. KPD says the city is looking at strengthening this business license applications process.
The preliminary hearing for a man accused of violently killing four University of Idaho students last fall will not happen next month. Instead, Brian Koberger is due back in court on Monday. This week, a grand jury indicted Koberger on four counts of murder and one count of burglary. Again, he had been scheduled to face a preliminary hearing in June, where lawyers would have laid out the evidence against him for a judge to decide if there was enough to merit a trial. The grand jury indictment changes the legal timeline in this case. An attorney in Eastern Washington says the move isn't surprising in a high-profile case like this one.
And so in this instance, they're bypassing that whole preliminary hearing, which was set to go on for a week, and kind of depriving the defense of the ability to cross-examine witnesses or to basically get a word in edgewise when it comes to the indictment.
Larson says the indictment shows how confident prosecutors feel about their case against Koberger. In order for an indictment like this to be issued, the prosecution has to bring forward all of their evidence.
And this is a sign that they're confident in their case, and obviously they've managed to get an indictment. But it's also a sign that they don't want to have to get bogged down in the preliminary hearing.
Coming up on Monday morning, Koberger will formally hear the charges from the grand jury, and then he's expected to enter a plea. If he pleads not guilty, the case will move towards a trial. We'll be keeping a close eye on what happens in court on Monday and bring you the latest on KAPP KVEW Local News. Tonight, the Biden administration is rolling out more changes intended to reduce homelessness nationwide 25% by 2025. The Interagency Council on Homelessness is partnering with governments in a half dozen places, including Seattle, to speed up efforts to get people into homes. The White House says that's going to include sending teams to help find ways to work through red tape and to figure out federal funding options. The Department of Housing and Urban Development goes out and counts the number of people on the streets once every year in January. In 2022, they say that number nationwide was over 580,000 people.
Well, fun in the sun and heat. Learn where you can enjoy some carnival entertainment in Eastern Washington. That's still to come.
Plus, a remarkable recovery. A local dog shot in the head months ago is now ready for the next chapter in her life.
And marking the aftermath of a deadly volcanic blast 43 years later. You're watching KAPP KVEW Local News at 6. We'll be right back.
Luxurious Karastan carpets are just the footing you need to live beautifully. And now, during National Karastan Month, you can save beautifully. Use your exclusive rebate to receive up to $1,000 back on select styles of Karastan carpets and the flawless craftsmanship of LuxCraft hard surface flooring. Live beautifully, save beautifully with Karastan at Floor and Home by Carpet One.
Come see us at Floor and Home.
Let us help create your space.
When you own a Ford, you get more than a vehicle. You get the benefit of having your vehicle picked up for service.
Here for the Explorer. All right, we'll get it right back to you.
This is U-Mode.
All the convenience of owning a Ford with a local partner. Corwin Ford Tri-City.
The savings continue with Bi-Mart's latest savings book. Out now and posted on Bi-Mart.com. Our 16-page book has store-wide savings in every department. Find what you need for spring home projects, inside and out, for less. Plus, find more membership savings in sporting goods, pantry essentials, and more. Save now with our latest savings book at Bi-Mart, your employee-owned membership store.
Reel in a fortune during the $200,000 Fishing for a Fortune at Wild Horse Resort and Casino. With over $7,000 in cash and prizes every Friday and Saturday. Cash your line and win up to $750 free play, $1,000 cash, or hook a new 15-foot Alaskan DLX boat. Play Wednesdays and multiply your entries. Use your club wild card and earn points and win special prizes from Billy's Bait Shop. Reel in your next fortune today. Wild Horse Resort and Casino, Pendleton, Oregon. More winners, more often.
At Affordable Dentures and Implants, we believe in the healing power of a new smile, the way it makes you look and feel, the way a smile lights up a room, so people can see the best version of you, which is why we make new smiles affordable for everyone, so you don't need to wait another day to get your smile back. Scan the QR code to learn more, or visit affordabledentures.com.
Go ahead and smile.
Now's the time to get a great deal on select Kubota equipment. Part of the number one rated tractor brand for durability and owner experience in the U.S., they offer the versatility and reliability to get the job done right all year round. Right now at participating dealers, get a Kubota compact tractor for zero down, 0% APR for 84 months.
Find a Kubota dealer near you at GoKubota.com.
When it comes to supplying the farm, come to Northwest Farm Supply. Your hometown store has a wide selection of everything egg-related. Plus, we're the largest Purina dealer in Hermiston. Products you trust from people who care. Northwest Farm Supply in Prosser, Hermiston, and Othello.
The Golf Forecast, sponsored by the Wild Horse Ladies Golf Classic, August 14th through 20th.
Welcome back. Police have responded in full force to two separate school shooting threats at Sela Middle School this week.
And since both were found not to be credible, some have said the large response went to waste. But KAPP's Emily Goodell talked to police and parents who say that is not the case.
I make it very clear to my guys, we will always respond as no matter what, as if it was an active shooter, as if people were in peril.
Sela Police Chief Dan Crispin says most of the time the threat isn't real, but it's never a waste of resources.
Yes, I understand that it's inconvenient. Yes, I understand that parents were off to work or other obligations, but the flip side to that is their kids are home tonight and they're safe and they haven't been injured or traumatized by an in-school shooting. So we're okay with that.
Because each threat tests their system, and so far it's working.
In both of these cases, we identified those responsible for the threats very rapidly, within an hour, their parents notified and in a room, and we were dealing with it.
And figuring out ways to improve if it happens again.
Like today, we realized that a lot of our resources were at one school, so we need to redistribute our resources. Every time that we do this, we see some little things that we can change and do better with in the future.
But for every threat, there are hundreds of parents who are worrying about their kids and wondering if today is the day that their child's life is in danger for real.
Parents like Leslie Corbin, who was called Monday to pick up her daughter after Sela Middle School canceled classes due to a shooting threat.
It kind of hits you when you're sitting there waiting and watching them walk out of the school with all the police around and everything, just how kind of serious it is. And it was pretty nerve-wracking.
She says communication from the school helped.
A lot of times we just have to hang tight and know that they're doing their best to handle the situation and that they'll keep us posted as they can.
She wishes her daughter could have contacted her at school, but her phone was locked away.
And I know it's a distraction and I know that it can cause a lot of problems, but in a situation like that, I wish that they would, if they brought their phone to class, to contact their parents, let us know that they're okay. I think that would be helpful.
Other community members have their own ideas about what they'd like to see happen in these situations.
There's a lot of opinions out there on Facebook, but are they going to the school board and, you know, talking about it there, where that's where it'll really make a difference.
Because it's likely not the last time it'll happen.
It's happening everywhere. The difference is how you handle it as a community. It makes a big difference.
In Sela, Emily Goodell, KAPP, local news.
Police say they're working on building a case against the students involved and will be forwarding that information to a prosecutor who will decide whether to file charges.
In Richland, the motorcyclist who was hurt in a crash yesterday did not have a license to drive a motorcycle and was at fault for the crash, according to authorities. Richland police say the motorcyclist was going eastbound on Keene Road at what they call a high rate of speed. They say he tried to pass vehicles using the bike lane. The vehicles were stopped at Westcliff Boulevard. Police say a motorist who was trying to turn left on green was then hit by the motorcyclist who they say ran the red light. The condition of that motorcyclist, not yet known.
The first steps are underway right now as the region prepares for the general and primary elections later this year. For candidates planning to run for office in 2023, filing week began just a couple days ago. It's an odd year election, which is generally the local races. This includes city councils, school boards, fire districts, water districts, and more. Benton County Auditor Brenda Chilton explains that the races this year are particularly important because it's the government closest to the people.
We're getting a lot of questions about the Richland School Board races, in particular the ones that we're currently processing recall petitions for three school board members, two of which are up for re-election this year. And so we have had some interest in those two races in particular.
If you're wanting to run for a local position, you only have until 4 p.m. on Friday to file if you're planning to be on the ballot in the primary and general election in 2023.
Well, 43 years ago tonight, Mount St. Helens erupted, the blast killing 57 people and literally changing the landscape of our state, leaving it covered in ash for hundreds of miles. 43 years later, a portion of the highway which provides access to the volcano has been cut off by a mudslide. We've been reporting all this week on Sunday's slide, which took out a bridge and left 11 people and a dog stranded overnight. The USGS says it was actually leftover debris from that 1980 eruption that caused Sunday's landslide.
Now, KAPP KVEW First Alert Weather with Jason Valentine.
Good Thursday evening, everyone. Folks getting close to that weekend. So we have records most likely snapping tomorrow and most likely on Saturday as well. More sunshine on deck and cooler by Sunday. So folks, let's get to those record highs. And folks, it looks like we'll see records throughout many of our areas, at least if the forecast comes through, except for in Ellensburg, where we expect to be about 4 degrees off the record. Other areas looking to break them. 4 degrees above the all-time record for Yakima. And folks, we are seeing increasing temperatures tomorrow and into Saturday. Could even see some upper 90s for the Mid-Columbia, Tri-Cities area. We're going to see that big cool down, though, come as we get to our next work week starting on Sunday. So we're going to get right near our average. So lower 80s to mid to upper 70s for all of our cities, at least to start our next work week. So cooler temperatures are on the way. We're definitely going to see our peak by Saturday. So our wind outlook, we have light winds today, and those winds are going to continue to look light until we get to Sunday. And we're going to see around 10 to 20 mile per hour winds. Then we'll slow back down to around 10 mile per hour as we head into our next work week as well. So no real wind events, but do expect breezy conditions for your Sunday. Now, our future cast, we do have some smoke coming in from those wildfires in Canada, and we are seeing some haze from that. So do expect to see some haze off and on as we move into our weekend. So our future cast, that shower activity or chance of it in Ellensburg, Yakima, moving on out. As we move into tomorrow, we're still going to see a little bit of a chance of shower activity in the Cascades, gently moving into the Yakima, Ellensburg areas. Very quick, though. We also have a bit of cells coming in from the southwest, but those look to dissipate before they really get to any of our cities, though we could see just a quick little shower to possibly Tri-Cities or Pendleton breaking through, but it'll be very fast if it does. So as we move into the next couple of days, again, we're seeing a little bit of shower activity in the Cascades, but we should be staying dry, at least mostly dry. So folks, in our almanac, today's record for Yakima is 98. That goes way down tomorrow and Saturday, where we should be seeing us break that. And we are still quite a bit above our averages. Now, this will change as we get into next week. We'll be much closer to what our averages are. So our golf forecast, a great weekend to do some golfing. Make sure you have the sunscreen. going to be 96 tomorrow, 98 Friday or Saturday, excuse me, and then 88 on Sunday. So a bit cooler, but do expect breezy conditions, especially as we get into Sunday. So overnight tonight, our overnight lows are going to be mostly in the 60s, 56 for Ellensburg and 59 for Pendleton. And again, clearing skies as we get into tomorrow. Plenty of sunshine, that record breaking heat for many of our cities, mid to lower 90s, and even warmer as we head into Saturday. Could see those upper 90s, and folks, we could be seeing triple digits, maybe at least near it. Should be the hottest day of 2023 so far. Then much cooler conditions as we get to the mid to lower 80s starting on Monday. Overnight lows getting back to the 50s, but look at those conditions. Very nice conditions. Same story for Yakima. Mid 90s through Saturday, and then upper 70s to lower 80s next week. So folks, get ready for more sunshine. Again, could be a little haze involved in that, as even as we get to the weekend. But folks, beautiful conditions, and if you need a break from the heat, it is on the way starting Sunday, but really delivering by Monday.
Okay, I think we're all aware that most cell companies only give you the lowest price when you sign up for multiple lines.
What? Multiple lines?
Hello? Yeah, one sec.
But U.S. Cellular gives you just one line for $29.99 with unlimited data.
Just one line with unlimited data.
So you don't have to get more lines than you need.
No, you hang up.
Are you even listening, guy who never looks up from his phone?
Oh, not for me, I just say it.
Okay, so no, you're not listening.
Get one line for $29.99, plus every plan is price protected. U.S. Cellular, built for us.
Shelter. Out here, it's the most important thing.
But the good thing is, my Ford F-150 provides enough power to keep working.
Get a great deal on an F-150, only at your local Ford dealer.
Come shop the largest selection of RVs in the Tri-Cities at Appleway RV. Save big on Class A's, Class C's, travel trailers, toy haulers, and fifth wheels. Shop America's top brands, Rockwood, Tiffin, Newmar, Dynamax, and more, with a huge selection of pre-owned RVs. Plus, get maximum value for your trade, all with no payments for 90 days. Come shop the clearance event at Appleway RV Pasco.
It's time. Time to let your soul breathe a little, to feel the sun on your face, and to feel alive again. It's time to dust off the clubs, to treat yourself, and test out your lungs. It's time to get away to the place that's not so far away, Lakeside Coeur d'Alene. Find countless ways to play and stay in CDA at visitcda.org.
There's no other word quite like home, because it's more than any specific place. It could be in the team spirit that keeps your heart pounding the whole drive over the mountains. It could be in the friendships that make you able to laugh at yourself. It's a feeling, a belonging, and that's really different for everyone. So while we can't define what home is to you, what we can do is help you get there.
Find your way home today in a new Chevrolet from McCurley Chevrolet.
At Honda, we offer complimentary maintenance for 2 years or 24,000 miles. Just enjoy the ride, knowing we cover routine items like oil changes, tire rotations, and multi-point inspections. Honda Service Pass, available to purchasers of all 2023 Honda vehicles. Get yours today.
That sound. Wolves. Boy, they sound hungry.
Load up, wolves!
Good thing this Ford Explorer has Sync3 technology. Keeps them entertained on the way to dinner.
Get a great deal on an Explorer, only at your local Ford dealer.
Smoke City for less. We are open 7 days a week with now 5 locations.
Welcome back, everyone. SELA Community Days starts today with a whole lot of family-friendly fun with rides, carnival games, fair food, and 85 vendors from across the state. Tonight is Buddy Night at the Carnival with a 2-for-1 special, and Young Life is serving up dinner at the SELA Civic Center. On Friday, the 26th annual Potato Feel and the Show and Shine Car Show. On Saturday, there's a pancake feed, grand parade, and fireworks. Sunday is the last chance to catch the carnival and play some bingo with the SELA Downtown Association.
I am most looking forward to seeing everybody come home. Not about the events, but it's about everybody coming together and gathering for community. That's what I'm most excited about.
The carnival is open until 9 o'clock tonight at Carlton Park. You can see a full schedule of all the events this weekend at SelaDays.com. We have a lot more news ahead in our next half hour. A film made in the Lilac City featuring not just iconic Northwest locations, but Eastern Washington residents. That film is about to celebrate a milestone. Details new tonight at 6:30.
This newscast sponsored by the Working Family Tax Credit.
With K2 Vision RLE, you can throw away your distance and reading glasses. Plus, you'll never develop a cataract. Schedule a free Zoom consultation with us today. K2 Vision RLE. No glasses, no contacts, no readers.
Luxurious Karastan carpets are just the footing you need to live beautifully. And now, during National Karastan Month, you can save beautifully. Use your exclusive rebate to receive up to $1,000 back on select styles of Karastan carpets and the flawless craftsmanship of LuxCraft hard surface flooring. Live beautifully. Save beautifully. With Karastan. At Floor and Home by Carpet One.
Come see us at Floor and Home.
Let us help create your space.
At West Richland Family Dental and Prime Dental Pasco, we are open from 7 a.m. until 7 p.m., Monday through Friday, plus Saturdays for when the week gets to be too full. West Richland Family Dental and Prime Dental Pasco, stunning smiles for the whole family.
This is how legends are.
2024 Chevy Silverado HD with Duramax Diesel. And the Chevy Silverado with powerful Turbomax engine. No matter what route you take, there's a Chevy truck to get you there. Find new roads. Get 1.9% financing on all 2023 Silverado 1500 LT Turbo Max pickups. Plus, get a $2,500 total cash allowance when you trade in an eligible vehicle. See your community Chevy dealers.
Your roof protects your home and family every day. Shouldn't it be the best roof possible? With Air Roofing, a family-owned business in Prosser, you'll see why our customer reviews speak for themselves. No job too small, big enough to take care of your roofing needs. Air Roofing, a company built on quality and reputation.
Make an experience this weekend to Vapiano. Relax in the country, experience the wine, and share in the joy. Vapiano awaits you and your friends. Make it a day to remember. Vapiano Estate and Winery. Slow down, enjoy the journey.
At the Blue Mountain Station Cooperative in Dayton, Washington, we offer you the Pacific Northwest's finest local products. Fresh baked goods, locally grown produce, artisan cheese, fresh roasted coffee, wine, honey, and so much more. We invite you to explore Dayton today.
Do you have any land that gets no use? Save some money by using an American-made power racking system. It's a more cost-effective option than a standard pole and concrete method. Invest in green energy with the pros at Solar Power Northwest. Solar Power Northwest, a better way to solar.
There's no other word quite like home, because it's more than any specific place. It could be in the team spirit that keeps your heart pounding the whole drive over the mountains. It could be in the friendships that make you able to laugh at yourself. It's a feeling, a belonging, and that's really different for everyone. So while we can't define what home is to you, what we can do is help you get there.
Find your way home today in a new Mazda from McCurley Mazda.
Hi, I'm Eddie Morphine from Morphine Law Firm. If you've been wronged and you need to make it right, give us a call. We're not afraid to fight. If you need an attorney with your best interests in mind, give us a call at Morphine Law Firm.
With K2 Vision RLE, you can throw away your distance and reading glasses. Plus, you'll never develop a cataract. Schedule a free Zoom consultation with us today. K2 Vision RLE. No glasses, no contacts, no readers.
Welcome back at New and Six, a firefighter making a difference for our most loyal companions.
Yeah, Umatilla Fire District 1 says when firefighters prepare for new positions, they undergo training, which includes choosing and completing a project. For his project, Lieutenant Spence looked for ways to care for pets and help them recover from smoke inhalation after they're rescued from a fire. Fire District has received 4 sets of pet oxygen masks to carry on its fire engines.
Some of these pictures you're seeing here show a Umatilla firefighter with that gear. The oxygen masks were donated thanks to the Project Breathe program from the Invisible Fence brand.
Oh, it looks like they have a precious little model to help them train on the mini oxygen masks.
Yes,
I love
we
it.
Hear this all the time. That,
yes.
You know, the people get out and then the dogs are trapped
Absolutely,
inside.
Absolutely, yes.
The more we can help them, the better.
Most definitely save the pets. Well, country music star about to enjoy a residency in Sin City.
Plus, we have an update on a sweet dog that survived a horrible tragedy. Now it's time to find her forever home.
And sparking change, the electric announcement for the Walla Walla School District. The news at 6:30 starts right now.
Now, KAPP KVEW local news at 6:30.
In this half hour with challenges to abortion access that's happening across the nation as some states enact new legislation.
Laura Aguirre reports.
South Carolina's abortion ban is one step closer to becoming law. Lawmakers advanced a House bill late Wednesday that restricts most abortions after 6 weeks. While heavily backed by Republicans, not every GOP member is in favor.
Abortion laws have always been, each and every one of them, about control. It's always about control.
Senator Sandy Senn says she and a bipartisan group of female lawmakers, calling themselves sister senators, will be ready to fight when that House bill comes back to their chamber.
All of the five women will be fighting against this bill. The big nail biter is going to be whether the three men who stood with us last time, whether they will stick with us.
In North Carolina, the governor speaking out after state Republicans overrode his veto on their 12-week ban Tuesday.
People are angry. Women feel like that they have been slapped in the face.
Virginia may soon be the only southern state without heavily restricted abortion access. Nebraska's State House filled with dueling protests Wednesday after a 12-week abortion ban was slipped into an already controversial bill that limits gender-affirming care for anyone under 19 years old.
I think today will be a very dark chapter in Nebraska history.
Nebraska's bill is expected to pass a final vote, possibly as soon as Friday. I'm Laura Aguirre reporting.
In Montana, the governor signed a 15-week abortion ban into law Tuesday. Planned Parenthood there filed an immediate legal motion to prevent its enforcement. In New Orleans, the Fifth Circuit Court of Appeals could soon rule on a Texas judge's suspension of the FDA's approval of the abortion pill. If upheld by the Fifth Circuit, the suspension could limit national access to that pill, which is used in the most common method of abortion available in the U.S. where it is legal.
The company that runs a fertility app is now agreeing to a proposed settlement over leaked health data. The app is called Premom, and it'll pay $200,000 in federal and state fines. That after authorities alleged it shared personal information of app users for years without their consent. That includes data shared with Google and two companies based in China. The app also can't share health data for advertising, and it has to ensure any data that is shared without user consent gets deleted from third-party systems. No comment yet from the company that operates the Premom app, but you may remember Washington Governor Jay Inslee signed House Bill 1155 into law, offering even more protection to private consumer health data.
Now to our weather, which requires sunglasses, maybe a hat. The heat is definitely back in our region, taking a live look outside tonight. Bit hazy out there, Alyssa.
A little bit. It's hot and smoky. It definitely doesn't feel like May, and it's only going to get hotter as we head into the weekend. Jason Valentine is tracking your First Alert forecast.
Good Thursday evening, everyone. Hope you're having a wonderful day today. And folks, hope you have a great weekend planned. We have really nice conditions on the way. Overnight tonight, we're going to see clearing into tomorrow and plenty of sunshine. We do have highs in the mid to lower 90s, and we do expect to be breaking some records tomorrow. And it looks like we'll be breaking those records on Saturday. So could see a hint of shower activity, Yakima, Ellensburg area as we head into the evening hours tonight, but then they'll be seeing some clearing as well. And as we move into Sunday, though, we have much cooler temperatures on the way, so do get ready for that. We're going to be back to the 80s, and then by next week we're going to be in the upper 70s to lower 80s. So we do have relief from this heat on the way, but again, record-breaking heat for many of our cities starting tomorrow into our Saturday. So folks, get ready for beautiful blue skies and plenty of sunshine to come even when we cool down. All that, my full forecast coming up, but for right now, I'm going to send it back to you.
Thank you, Jason. The Biden administration has warned that spending cuts that Republicans are demanding in exchange for raising the debt ceiling could put programs like the effort to fight homelessness in jeopardy. This as the June 1st deadline, when we're expecting to see a catastrophic default, is now only 2 weeks away. John Lawrence is tracking negotiations on Capitol Hill.
Discussions about the looming debt ceiling remain grounded.
I mean, a default on the Treasury debt, I can state with a high degree of confidence that would be catastrophic.
That's why some Democratic lawmakers want President Joe Biden to invoke the 14th Amendment, which would allow him to raise the spending cap without Congress's approval.
The United States Constitution, Article 14, says that the United States has to pay its bills. It's in the Constitution.
Section 4 of the 145-year-old amendment says, quote, the validity of the public debt of the United States authorized by law, including debts incurred for payment of pensions and bounties for services in suppressing insurrection or rebellion, shall not be questioned.
I've heard people say, well, it might be a way we can do this. And once you start down that slope, then no one's ever going to take the seriousness of our debt.
As some Republicans blast Democrats for inaction,
their only plan, which is no plan at all, is to ignore this fiscal crisis and do nothing to limit spending, save taxpayer dollars, or grow the economy.
House Speaker Kevin McCarthy wants President Biden to focus on the country's financial status.
Mr. President, even as senator, you voted no on many of these debt ceilings because you said you were upset that there wasn't enough savings.
I'm John Lawrence reporting.
The National Transportation Safety Board says 10,000 bridges across the U.S. need to be inspected for a potential safety hazard. During the inspection into a 2022 bridge collapse in Pittsburgh, inspectors say they found corrosion in some places so severe it caused holes in the bridge's legs. The NTSB says the uncoated weathering steel had not been properly maintained in this case. The board is urging the Federal Highway Administration to work with departments of transportation across the U.S. to inspect the 10,000 bridges made with that material.
We have new information tonight about the Massachusetts Air National Guardsman accused of leaking classified material online. The Pentagon now says he had been reprimanded multiple times before his arrest. ABC's Em Nguyen has a look at what we've learned about his record.
The Air National Guardsman charged with leaking classified intelligence was warned repeatedly by superiors about his handling of military secrets, yet was allowed continued access, according to new court filings by prosecutors. While the Justice Department argues 21-year-old Jack Teixeira's willful disregard of his obligations, the incidents listed are raising new questions about Air Force management.
It was troubling on many levels.
In September 2022, one memo states Air Force officials caught Teixeira taking notes on classified information and that he put a note into his pocket before he was told by superiors not to take notes in any form. In October, a second memo reported that Teixeira attended a meeting and asked very specific questions to which he was instructed to again cease and desist and focus on his job. That memo also mentioned that Teixeira was potentially ignoring the cease and desist order. And in February, a third memo states a superior found Teixeira viewing intelligence unrelated to his primary duty. It's unclear if the Air Force ever disciplined Teixeira or rescinded his security clearance. Congressman Michael McCaul speaking on CNN.
After the warnings, he should have been taken off that job.
Prosecutors also say it's clear the dissemination of classified national defense information was even more widespread than previously known.
There's not a lot of good reasons why one would do that, other than breaking the law and potentially committing espionage.
Teixeira has yet to enter a plea. He's due back in court tomorrow, where a judge will decide whether he'll remain in custody pending trial. Em Nguyen, ABC News, Washington.
New at 6:30, Walla Walla making history. Its school district becoming one of the first in eastern Washington to get an electric school bus. The district already has the first bus, with two others set to arrive over the summer. According to the Walla Walla School District, the electric school bus can travel up to 300 miles on a single charge in ideal driving conditions. It does have fewer moving parts, which the district says means less maintenance. Money to purchase the buses came from a Department of Ecology grant, which also paid for the charging stations. You can get a closer look at the bus at a ribbon-cutting ceremony that is coming up next week. That is on May 30th at 10 in the Southeast Washington Transportation Cooperative in Walla Walla. The first bus will begin serving routes later this month.
As the thunder rolls, so does Garth Brooks. Learn more about his Vegas residency, the details still to come.
Plus, she survived being shot. Now this beautiful dog is ready for a loving family.
And it is hot and humid in our region with more heat in the First Alert forecast. That's next on KAPP KVEW Local News at 6:30.
The golf forecast, sponsored by the Wild Horse Ladies Golf Classic, August 14th through 20th.
It's time.
time to let your soul breathe a little, to feel the sun on your face, and to feel alive again, it's time to dust off the clubs, to treat yourself, and test out your lungs. It's time to get away to the place that's not so far away, Lakeside Coeur d'Alene. Find countless ways to play and stay in CDA at visitcda.org.
Shelter. Out here, it's the most important thing.
But the good thing is, my Ford F-150 provides enough power to keep working.
Get a great deal on an F-150, only at your local Ford dealer.
Reel in a fortune during a $200,000 Fishing for a Fortune at Wild Horse Resort and Casino. With over $7,000 in cash and prizes every Friday and Saturday. Cash your line and win up to $750 free play, $1,000 cash, or hook a new 15-foot Alaskan DLX boat. Play Wednesdays and multiply your entries. Use your club wild card and earn points and win special prizes from Billy's Bait Shop. Reel in your next fortune today. Wild Horse Resort and Casino, Pendleton, Oregon. More winners, more often.
Now's the time to get a great deal on select Kubota equipment. Part of the number one rated tractor brand for durability and owner experience in the U.S., they offer the versatility and reliability to get the job done right, all year round. Right now at participating dealers, get a Kubota compact tractor for zero down, 0% APR for 84 months.
Find a Kubota dealer near you at GoKubota.com.
From KAPP KVEW, this is Legally Speaking.
Hi, I'm Eddie Morphine of Morphine Law Firm. As an attorney, I want you to know that when you hire a lawyer, you are in charge. The attorney works for you. Now, whether you've been involved in an auto accident, have a Consumer Protection Act situation, or have a personal injury claim, the attorney is there to look out for your best interests. Now, if they're not doing that, you have the right to seek different legal representation. Remember, if you've been wronged, we want to help make it right. We offer free, no-obligation consultations. Call us at Morphine Law Firm. Let us answer your questions. And if legal representation is right for you, we'll provide you with the legal representation you need. We're not afraid to fight for you. Call us at Morphine Law Firm in Kennewick. 509-380-9999.
The heartbreaking story that stunned the nation. Hours after saying I do and driving away in a golf cart, they were hit by an allegedly drunk driver. Now, after losing the love of his life, he shares his story for the first time on GMA.
That sound. Wolves. Boy, they sound hungry.
Load up, wolves!
Good thing this Ford Explorer has Sync 3 technology. Keeps them entertained on the way to dinner.
Get a great deal on an Explorer, only at your local Ford dealer.
A Supreme Court decision, or non-decision, that is sure to have an impact on the tech industry. Twitter, Facebook, and Google were facing lawsuits accused of allowing posts and videos that radicalized people, leading to terror attacks. Now, typically, online platforms aren't held liable for the things that people post, much like gun makers aren't held liable for what people do with their weapons. But the lawsuits before the Supreme Court claimed that the platforms let people use them to plan attacks, and then they say those platforms didn't do enough to make sure that terrorism-related posts were taken down and taken out of the algorithm. Today, the justices said that lawsuits didn't prove that tech companies deliberately intended to help terrorists. So they rejected one lawsuit. They sent the other back to a lower court. Now, again, this is basically a non-decision. So we could see this issue come up before the Supreme Court again in the future.
And while many government offices are now banning TikTok from official devices, Montana has banned it from the entire state starting next year. Users would not be punished. The law would fine TikTok or entity like app stores $10,000 per day for each time it allows someone to access the app. There's still questions around how this will be enforced.
There is some irony that such a ban would require the creation of technology that is similar to, you know, oppressive technology that China has pioneered.
It hurts just because it's like one of the three main platforms that like I've built a community on. It's the biggest one I've built a community on. But as a content creator, you kind of always have to adapt.
The big concern for opponents is that data from TikTok might be shared with China's government. TikTok officials say all of the data from American users is stored in the United States and is not connected to China.
We have an update tonight on Ricky the Husky that someone shot in the head last September. The dog is now doing much better. She's spayed, vaccinated, and microchipped. These pictures coming to us from Mikey's Chance Rescue. The dog is in foster care right now. She is looking for her forever home, though. Please note that Ricky has special needs now, but she could provide a family with a loving new member. If you're interested in adopting, please submit an application with Mikey's Chance Rescue.
Now, KAPP KVEW First Alert Weather with Jason Valentine.
Good Thursday evening, everyone. Folks getting close to that weekend. So we have records most likely snapping tomorrow and most likely on Saturday as well. More sunshine on deck and cooler by Sunday. So folks, let's get to those record highs. And folks, it looks like we'll see records throughout many of our areas, at least if the forecast comes through, except for in Ellensburg, where we expect to be about 4 degrees off the record. Other areas looking to break them. 4 degrees above the all-time record for Yakima. And folks, we are seeing increasing temperatures tomorrow and into Saturday. Could even see some upper 90s for the Mid-Columbia, Tri-Cities area. We're going to see that big cool down, though, come as we get to our next work week starting on Sunday. So we're going to get right near our average. So lower 80s to mid to upper 70s for all of our cities, at least to start our next work week. So cooler temperatures are on the way. We're definitely going to see our peak by Saturday. So our wind outlook, we have light winds today, and those winds are going to continue to look light until we get to Sunday. And we're going to see around 10 to 20 mile per hour winds. Then we'll slow back down to around 10 mile per hour as we head into our next work week as well. So no real wind events, but do expect breezy conditions for your Sunday. Now, our future cast, we do have some smoke coming in from those wildfires in Canada, and we are seeing some haze from that. So do expect to see some haze off and on as we move into our weekend. So our future cast, that shower activity or chance of it in Ellensburg, Yakima, moving on out. As we move into tomorrow, we're still going to see a little bit of a chance of shower activity in the Cascades, gently moving into the Yakima, Ellensburg areas. Very quick, though. We also have a bit of cells coming in from the southwest, but those look to dissipate before they really get to any of our cities, though we could see just a quick little shower or two, possibly Tri-Cities or Pendleton breaking through, but it'll be very fast if it does. So as we move into the next couple of days, again, we're seeing a little bit of shower activity in the Cascades, but we should be staying dry, at least mostly dry. So folks, in our almanac, today's record for Yakima is 98. That goes way down tomorrow and Saturday, where we should be seeing us break that. And we are still quite a bit above our averages. Now, this will change as we get into next week. We'll be much closer to what our averages are. So our golf forecast, a great weekend to do some golfing. Make sure you have the sunscreen. Going to be 96 tomorrow, 98 Friday or Saturday, excuse me, and then 88 on Sunday. So a bit cooler, but do expect breezy conditions, especially as we get into Sunday. So overnight tonight, our overnight lows are going to be mostly in the 60s, 56 for Ellensburg and 59 for Pendleton. And again, clearing skies as we get into tomorrow. Plenty of sunshine, that record breaking heat for many of our cities, mid to lower 90s, and even warmer as we head into Saturday. Could see those upper 90s, and folks, we could be seeing triple digits, maybe at least near it. Should be the hottest day of 2023 so far. Then much cooler conditions as we get to the mid to lower 80s starting on Monday. Overnight lows getting back to the 50s, but look at those conditions. Very nice conditions. Same story for Yakima. Mid 90s through Saturday, and then upper 70s to lower 80s next week. So folks, get ready for more sunshine. Again, could be a little haze involved in that as even as we get to the weekend. But folks, beautiful conditions, and if you need a break from the heat, it is on the way starting Sunday, but really delivering by Monday.
Thanks, Jason. We have a lot more news to share with you on our mobile app. You can use the camera on your smartphone to scan this QR code, which is also at the bottom of your screen throughout the show. The code takes you right to our app for news and weather on demand. It's free to download, and there's no subscription fee. We'll be right back after the break.
My mom hired Bath Fitter to make me a new bath. My friend Jimmy said that when he got a new bath, it took forever. Jimmy didn't have to take a bath for a month. I didn't even get to miss one bath. It's just not fair.
Bathfitter will remodel your bath in as little as one day. We've got over 2 million satisfied customers and 35 years experience. Call now or visit bathfitter.com for a free in-home consultation.
This is how legends are. 2024 Chevy Silverado HD with Duramax diesel. And the Chevy Silverado with powerful TurboMax engine. No matter what route you take, there's a Chevy truck to get you there. Find new roads. Get 1.9% financing on all 2023 Silverado 1500 LT Turbo Max pickups. Plus, get a $2,500 total cash allowance when you trade in an eligible vehicle. See your community Chevy dealers.
Are you interested in a top-load laundry set? See the best selection of top-load laundry sets anywhere at Fred's Memorial Day sale.
Like this Hot Point top-load set. Top-load washers and dryers start at $4.99 each.
GE top-load laundry sets have features like a water station for hand rinsing, sensor drying, and deep fill for your biggest loads.
Buy one pedestal and get the second one free on select front-load models.
GE laundry sets are on sale and in stock. Stop by today at Fred's Memorial Day sale.
What's important to me when I look for a place to work is somewhere that shares the same morals and values that I have. What attracted me to working at McCurley is just how much they do for the community. I mean, they do a lot for Trot, Therapeutic Riding of Tri-Cities, which I have a personal connection with. My son Caden, he has autism and he goes there. And I just was like, you know what, McCurley would be the best place for me to work. What I love most about what I do is I'm a champion for my customers. Like, hey, I'm here to help you get into the best vehicle possible, the vehicle that works for you, and I'm gonna listen to you. Everything that you're needing, I'm gonna help you and find that for you. We care about our customers and making sure that they get into the best and safest vehicle possible. I'm Taylor Boyce, and I'm driving change at McCurley.
Find your way home and help make an impact in our community in a new Chevrolet from McCurley Chevrolet.
Cut your ties to the fuel pump with an all-electric vehicle from Overturf Kia. You'll find a great selection of new vehicles in stock now. Lease the 2023 all-electric Kia EV6 Wind with all-wheel drive for just $579 per month or purchase for $53,849. Take delivery today or reserve a car that's on its way. Shop online anytime at OverturfKia.com. Overturf Kia at the base of the Blue Bridge in Kennewick.
Live with Kelly and Mark, weekday mornings at 9 on KAPP-KVEW.
A milestone for the Lilac City this summer, Spokane will celebrate the 30th anniversary of the film Benny and June this July. The film, starring Johnny Depp and Mary Stuart Masterson, has special meaning to Spokane residents, especially those who appeared on the screen as extras in the movie. To celebrate the anniversary, a group of those extras, along with fans of the movie, will make a short film sharing their experience from the time Hollywood showed up in Spokane. The movie featured several Spokane landmarks, such as Riverfront Park or a local cafe named Ferguson's.
Of course, Ferguson's is where one of the most iconic scenes of that film was shot, right there, you know, with Johnny Depp and the forks and the rolls.
Don Hamilton, whose film studio is putting this short film together, says this movie made a lasting impression on Spokane, which is clear when so many parts of the city are easily recognizable.
Well, Garth Brooks kicks off his Vegas residency at the Coliseum at Caesars Palace tonight. He's coming off a world tour last year and co-hosting the ACMs earlier this month. Garth told ABC News he's planning to stay in Vegas at least until next year.
I'm hoping they get something here that they can't get anywhere else. I think it's a laboratory because no phone policy, no video policy, which makes me go, here's a song I was working on today. When somebody buys a ticket and receives something that money can't buy, that's hopefully when you've done what I think you're down here to do.
I see the emotion on your face. I hear it in your voice. Why is it there?
I just can't believe this happened. It's one of those things that's kind of weird. I think I'll go to my grave thinking this might be the only time God made a mistake. You know, it's like, how is this happening? How do people show up?
The show is called Garth Brooks Plus One, and that does mean there will be unannounced guest stars depending on the night. Tickets for next year's dates will be available starting next week. And Maddie, the big question tonight has been, would you give up your phone to see Garth Brooks in concert?
Phone, iPad, computer, credit card number, whatever, Garth, you get it.
You probably need to give up all of it.
Absolutely, yes. Fantastic for him. I mean, it's wonderful to see a country superstar be choked up over something like Vegas when he's won multiple awards. You know, just an incredible artist, so good for him.
Yes, always love to hear him.
You're watching KAPP KV Local News at 6:30. We're back with a final check of your forecast coming up next.
With K2 Vision RLE, you can throw away your distance and reading glasses. Plus, you'll never develop a cataract. Schedule a free Zoom consultation with us today. K2 Vision RLE. No glasses, no contacts, no readers.
Are you making these money mistakes that will
ruin your employees?
Act rich, get rich.
It's new. It's gross. It's Bitcoin. Crypto, baby! Are you wondering how am I making money? How am I traveling the world and just living my best life? Well, it's pretty easy, okay?
See what I mean? Let's talk about managing your money in real life.
Mom, get out of here!
Thank you.
Find a healthier approach to money at Giza.
This all-new Aria
is an elegant EV.
Yeah, with 389 horsepower. And all-wheel drive. Ooh.
It's beautiful.
It's a beast.
It's electric.
With an edge.
Oh, let's go with that.
Get a low $429 per month lease or get 2.99% financing for 36 months on the all-new Aria.
Come shop the largest selection of RVs in the Tri-Cities at Appleway RV. Save big on Class A's, Class C's, travel trailers, toy haulers, and fifth wheels. Shop America's top brands, Rockwood, Tiffin, Newmar, Dynamax, and more with a huge selection of pre-owned RVs. Plus, get maximum value for your trade, all with no payments for 90 days. Come shop the clearance event at Appleway RV Pasco.
Make your first move with battery power made by Steel. Right now, save $50 on the FSA 57 battery trimmer. Real Steel. Find yours.
At Bruce Heating and Air, your comfort is our business. With over 30 years of professional HVAC experience for residential and commercial properties, you can rest assured your heating and air system is in good hands. In addition to providing quality heating, air conditioning, ventilation, and installation services, Bruce Heating and Air also houses a full-service sheet metal fabrication shop.
Now through June 30th, receive rebates up to $2,100 off on a new Daikin Fit system when you finance through Bruce Heating and Air.
With K2 Vision RLE, you can throw away your distance and reading glasses. Plus, you'll never develop a cataract. Schedule a free Zoom consultation with us today. K2 Vision RLE. No glasses, no contacts, no readers.
ET, followed by Extra, tonight at 7 on KAPP KVEW.
Welcome back, everyone. Let's take another look outside right now. The heat has definitely returned to the region and looking to stick around for a while.
It's hot and it's smoky out there, but we were talking about this earlier. It does not feel like May. It's really feeling more like August at this point. Dealing with the wildfire smoke that's coming down from Canada, it's been impacting our air quality. We're now sitting at moderate for most of our region. We'll be tracking that for you to see if it gets worse. But in the meantime, Jason Valentine has a check on your first alert forecast.
All right, everyone, let's get you ready for your Friday. Tomorrow, plenty of sunshine for the Tri-Cities, highs mid-90s. If we reach that, that will be a record. Also a record for Yakima, plenty of sunshine as well, right around 92, 93. Walla Walla in the mid to lower 90s as well. And in Ellensburg, looking nice, right around 90 degrees. Ellensburg may miss the record. Their record is 94. But most of our regions will see record highs for Friday and Saturday. Have a wonderful evening.
All right. Going to be a toasty one this weekend.
Stay hydrated.
Bring out the sunscreen. Absolutely. Thank you so much for watching. KAPP KV Local News is always on at yaktrainnews.com.
And we're back tonight at 11.